a particle of a specific charge, charge to mass ratio, alpha, starts moving from the origin under the action of an electric field E is equal to E naught I cap and magnetic field B equal to B naught K cap. Its velocity at X naught, Y naught, 0 is 4 I cap plus 3 J cap. So, the first thing is that here Q by M is given to you as alpha. And the particle starts from origin, means initial velocity of the particle V1 is 0. And when it reaches the point X0, Y0, 0, at that point its velocity V2 becomes 4 I cap plus 3 J cap. That means the magnitude of V2 will be how much? Under root 16 plus 9, 25, so it is 5 meter per second or whatever. Units are not specified. Here one thing we know for sure, that magnetic field has no effect on speed, because magnetic force always acts perpendicular to velocity. That means whatever is the gain in kinetic energy, that is because of the electric force. And here electric field is constant, E naught I cap, means direction wise as well as the magnitude wise electric field is constant. So its work done can be calculated by simply multiplying the force with the displacement in the direction of the force, which is x coordinate only. So work done by electric force will be Q E naught into x naught by this time, and it must be equal to change in kinetic energy. So final kinetic energy, half m V2 square, so V2 is 5, minus initial kinetic energy, half m V1 square, that was 0. So it becomes 25 m divided by 2. Here it is Q E naught x naught. So Q by m E naught x naught is how much? 25 by, so in place of Q by m we can write alpha into E naught into x naught is equal to 25 divided by 2. So what we have got is x naught equal to 25 divided by 2 alpha E naught. So which option is correct? Obviously option C is the correct option.